Hi guys, I got a lot of questions on my last video about Bitcoin Cash. As I mentioned that I'm eyeing to buy this during the bear market, but people don't understand why. So I'll give you my why, and I hope it helps you in making a decision whether to buy it or not, or it could help you just to make better decisions in general, because it's a personal decision. I think that there will be several cryptocurrencies that will be very successful, it's like investing in companies. You really have to invest in companies that that you really believe in, that you feel good about. You believe in a strategy. you like the people involved. It just fits with your personality. It's always a good choice. Same with girls. It's really important to choose a girl that you really like. And if you don't really like her, let her go. It's the same with investments in crypto. And you can switch. Like, things change. And so I like Bitcoin Cash today, but that may change in the future. And I will certainly switch then to another coin, another crypto coin, very likely. So why do I like Bitcoin Cash? Well, I really believe in it. I think that Bitcoin Cash is doing an amazing job in finding adoption. Like the drive I see with people that believe in Bitcoin Cash is very high. And I have the same. Like, I can convince people to start using Bitcoin Cash because I really believe in the story. The story is very simple. It's a story that Bitcoin at the time was, which is that, well, nobody can issue more Bitcoin, so that's limited. Nobody is also like making money of it, like, except for miners. But miners actually have very high expenses, and they make profits sometimes, but sometimes they make losses too. And they provide security in exchange, but nobody else is getting paid for it, and that means it's a voluntary project. And that, of course, has disadvantages, like we saw with Bitcoin. It can cause problems, but it can also work, as Bitcoin proved. I believe that if people start using Bitcoin Cash and saving Bitcoin Cash, they will do very well financially. And that's just very important. And I also really like the ideology behind Bitcoin Cash, because that's why I am in crypto. The ideology is that it's a private currency. It competes with state currencies, with fiat, and it's here to build a better world. A lot of the misery in the world is because money goes down in value, because the government prints more and more every day and basically puts it into stuff that does not create a return, and that's why the value of the money goes down. It's basically stealing. It's the same as if a shareholder, a CEO of a company, would issue more and more shares and give it to himself without increasing the value of the company enough to compensate for that loss. This is what's happening with fiat all the time, and I think really causes a lot of poverty. Just like taxes, I think causes a lot of poverty, inflation also. It's the same as with communism. It caused a lot of poverty, that you couldn't start your own business. Every business was owned by the state, and so you get a very poor businesses. Like, at the time, if you would go in Russia to a cafe or a restaurant, well, they wouldn't serve you. It would be dirty tables. And sure, it's free or very cheap, but it's a very bad experience. Or the people would go to the butcher to get free sausages, but actually they would stand or free bread, but they would stand in line for weeks to get served. So it doesn't work. The state, the government should not be running businesses. But it's the same with money. The state should not be running currencies because they do a very poor job. Or the state should not be running roads because they do a very poor job. Or the state should not be running schools or hospitals or buses or public transport. Like, it's always a much poorer job than if you let the private market do it. You'll get a much richer experience. For example, here in Kenya, behind me, you see all these buses pass. Well, look at these buses. They all look different. Okay, there is still a lot of pollution in countries like this. But, like, people, if they want to take a bus, they have it immediately because there are so many buses. It's private buses. They compete with each other. It's extremely cheap prices. You have buses with music. You have buses with TV. There are problems, of course, also, but I mean, the government could never offer such a cheap public transport as the private sector can, and that's the case in with everything, but also with currencies. Like, we have a so you know the story. If you've been in cryptocurrency, you know the story, but this story is still valid with Bitcoin Cash. And of course, like, you could say Bitcoin offers that also, but Bitcoin, the transaction fees have gone up a lot due to decisions the Bitcoin Core team has made. And it's true that right now the Bitcoin transaction fees are down again, but the moment it's going to get busy again, it's going to go up again. It's just an economic law. If you limit the amount of transactions that can be processed, and then you, like, allow only the transactions that pay the highest transaction fee to pass, of course you're going to get high transaction fees when it gets busy. Now, like, it's the same with these buses here, Matatus. When it's raining, the prices go up. When it's peak hour, the prices go up. There's nothing bad about that. But with a digital cryptocurrency, you don't need to do that because the amount of space, digital space, is unlimited. Like, the amount that goes up very fast, disk space, processor time. So it's an artificial, unnecessary limit that costs these high transaction fees, and that's just, like, really not necessary. And so competitors that don't do that will, of course, get the market. It's a very simple. And this is what is happening right now with Bitcoin Cash. Many merchants stop at accepting Bitcoin and start accepting Bitcoin Cash. If you're willing to look at that, to do your own research, you will see that happening right now. And so that's basically one company losing the market, another company winning the market. So this is very important to notice. And as an investor, it's your job to reward companies and coins that do a great job in offering value to people, in getting adopted. For cryptocurrencies, for companies, you can look at the growth rates and also the profit margins, of course. But for currencies, you cannot look at the profit margins, but you can look at the growth rate. And if you look at that for Bitcoin Cash, the transactions are going up very fast, which is what you really need. The rate that the transactions go up in Bitcoin Cash is the same rate as Ethereum. So it's a leader. For me, for example, Ethereum, I think, also offers these, like, a great story, like, and just a lot of evidence that they have fast growth and that they have a bright future. But the problem for me with Ethereum is that the story is too complex. It's not my field of expertise to judge crypto platforms. I've tried it with NXT and I failed. And I think also that why did I start investing in other cryptocurrencies at the time? Because of Bitcoin maximalism. I really thought that was so misguided to have the belief that we should have one crypto, one blockchain, one development team. Like, at the time, I really couldn't find myself in that. I believe in a free market, I believe in competition, and the arrogance that I noticed already like 2 years, 3 years back in the Bitcoin community, I found so misguided, and at the time Bitcoin was still 90% market dominance. That's why I very quickly started to invest in other coins and open up to it. First it was Litecoin, and later it was NXT and many other coins. But today, the market has changed a lot. There is still Bitcoin maximalism in Bitcoin, and there is also Bitcoin maximalism in Bitcoin Cash. But it's down a lot in the Bitcoin Cash community. Like, you also have a big piece of that community that really also believes in a free market, that does not believe any longer in one chain, like in basically trying to get a monopoly. No, I think and also of course today, like, Bitcoin was valued very highly at the time, even though in fiat was valued a lot lower. In the cryptocurrency community at the time when it had 90% dominance, it was already valued very highly, and the opportunity was elsewhere, in coins that were valued only at 1% or less of the market cap, but actually had a bright future. Many coins have gone up in market share. Monero, Dash, Ethereum, so many, all at the expense of Bitcoin. But today, we don't have that anymore. Today, with Bitcoin Cash, what you have is that actually this is not a big project. It's one of the bigger projects, but the market share is only like 5% or so. And it has a lot of potential to gain in market share. Because, yeah, I think Bitcoin has lost a lot of market share due to these high transaction fees. Many coins have gotten a chance to grow because many users were just pushed away from Bitcoin. They had to find an alternative. And so they went to Dash to pay merchants, or they went to Monero to go to make payments on the black market, or they went to Ethereum just to pay for investments or trade currencies or transfer from one exchange to another or lose Litecoin for that. Like, all the other coins have benefited from that. But today, this will likely reverse to Bitcoin Cash. Because what's the big advantage of Bitcoin Cash compared to all these other coins? Well, it has this just a simple focus of being a currency to be used with merchants and a simple payments. So it's a simple story, but also it has the brand name of Bitcoin, and this is so important, and also a cause of big conflict and a lot of hate towards Bitcoin Cash. But if you try to convince a newcomer to start using cryptocurrency, the only thing they know is Bitcoin. They don't even know Ethereum. They don't know Dash or Monero or Bytebal. So you have to do a lot more work there to get them started with that. But with Bitcoin, they know the name. It's a very easy sell. And this is something that Bitcoin Cash has. And when I have to explain to people, totally newcomers, okay, what to invest in, I can explain very easily, invest in Bitcoin. But be careful, because you have two Bitcoins now. You have Bitcoin BTC and you have Bitcoin BC Hash. It's basically the project split in two. You have two Bitcoins. But I think Bitcoin Cash is a much better investment because, well, it's a lot cheaper, but also it's growing a lot faster in amount of transactions, and you're sure the transaction fees are not going to go up in the future. And so this is an easy sell. And that's very important, because this will also determine the value of the coin in the future. It's not just only for me. It's for everybody that talks about, everybody that tries to sell a crypto to his peers will have a much easier job in selling Bitcoin Cash and in selling Ethereum or Monero or Dash, just because of the brand recognition. So I think these are some important points. I hope it made sense for you. And please post your questions below if there are things you don't understand, and I'm happy to make another video in it with the questions. Thanks so much for watching. I wish you all a great day.